Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. Okay, so this question belongs to GATE CSE 2008. The question is, consider the minterms list from the for the Boolean function f given below. So basically they give the minterms as well as the don't care condition, and they are asking the number of essential prime implicants. Okay, so let us draw the k map for four variables. Okay, I think the diagram is a bit big, but it's okay for us. Okay, so it is a P, Q and R, S, right? So P, Q, P, Q, P, Q, P, Q, R, S, R, S, R, S, R, S, bar, 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 bar. Okay, so let me write down the numbers with some other color. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. Got it? Yes. So let us start. So minterms. So at 1, at 2, at 5, at 7, at 9, at 11. Okay. And don't care at 3, at 8. Okay. At 10, at 12, at 14. Okay. Yes. So I think we have marked everything, right? So just give me a second. I'll be cross checking it, so that we will not be doing any kind of mistakes here. Okay. Okay, so just give me a second, guys, so that I can just cross-check it carefully, so that, okay. So I think mostly we have covered everything. Okay, yes. So anyway, let us start solving this, guys. Okay, yes. Okay, so let us start. So if you observe carefully, to cover these two ones, the best method is to take the four corner piece, right? Yes. So what is that four corner piece of value name, guys? That is nothing but Q bar and S bar. Q bar, S bar. Nice. And now moving on to the next thing. That is, you can take these four, right? To take these two numbers. So you can take these four as a pair. So what is this pair? This is nothing but P bar, Q bar. Okay. And the last one pair, the left out ones, these two guys you can take as one, because those are not having any chance for making four or more. So the only chance is two. Okay. So this is nothing but P bar Q. Yes. Right. Yes. So these are the three essential prime implicants. So basically there are only three essential prime implicants. That's it. There are no implicants and anything else. Right. Yes. There are no prime implicants and anything else. Okay. Yes. So now I hope everyone got a clear idea. Right. So there are total three mandatory prime implicants. Got it? Yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to this question. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.